am Ninjin. I am originally from Mongolia, but I've been living in the States for 5 years. And I'm 16, and I've been doing origami for 14 years, about 14 years. I am interested in origami because it's just very fun to do. I've been doing it for a really long time. It just seems very practical and fun. You can gift these things to people. And I actually don't remember why I was attracted to origami. When I was in kindergarten, when I was about 2, there was a Japanese teacher who was teaching us origami and Japanese. Though I've never been taught Japanese in kindergarten, I've been taught origami by that teacher. So I think it started then. So I actually don't know why I liked it really much, but I did continue doing it. And in elementary school, lots of my classmates were really interested in origami, and we would teach each other things. Like this one was taught to me by one of my classmates. He was in, I think, 4th grade when he taught me this. So it was really hard to make at first, but it's good now. And these are the works that I made. These are flower coasters, so you can put your teacups. And this is a butterfly chopstick stand. This is a lotus flower. And this is a stand-up heart that I've been gifting to people a lot. And these are jars of lucky stars. I do have 99 of them in each jar, so they're supposed to symbolize eternity. I like you for eternity, and I think there's a legend about these stars. So if you're interested in that, I can tell you later. So today I'm going to teach the lotus flower and how to make these lucky stars. So today I'm going to teach this lotus flower or a water lily. So here. First we are going to prep the paper by folding it. So you're going to fold it, make a rectangle, make sure they match up, go halfway, turn it so it's not crooked when you finish it, and then let them meet in the mid. Alright, unfold, and we're going to do the same right here. Make sure they meet, go midway, and then make sure they meet right here also, go midway, and then fold. We're going to unfold it again and make a triangle. So this one is a bit tricky. You have to start, make sure first that they meet. Start in the middle. Okay, and then go here. Alright, and make sure that they match and make a perfect angle. And then you push, make a line right here, do the same right here. Let's fold it so it's easier to see. Just gently push it until they make a good angle. And then, there you go. So we're going to do the same. I'm folding it right here. So let them meet right here, do the middle. Gently push it until they make a good pointy angle. Let's see. Okay.
this one's being a bit stubborn. Okay, good. And here too. And when you're prepping, be sure that these are not wonky, as it'll determine the whole outcome. It's like a grid where you look both olive. So very important. Make sure that's straight. Alright, so it's done. Now I'm going to fold each corner to the center. Just follow the grid that you have here. So there's the center. Just don't push it like this. Do the same here. Make sure that they are perfectly straight. And go here. And make sure that these make an angle too. Alright. I'm going to make it I'll check every corner before I fully push it down. Alright. It's a bit crooked. We can fix it. Pushing around like this. Alright. So we're done. There's a bit of gap there, but it's alright. We're going to fold it again. The same way to the center. And this time we're going to do the opposite sides for each, since these paper, as you can see, try to ride up when you fold them. So just hold it down and push it. Alright, do this one. Make sure they make a good angle right here. Alright, and after this, we are going to flip the paper. And that's that. We are going to do the same right here. Just folding it, folding the corners to the center, to the opposites. At this time, the paper is going to be very thick, so just make sure that you push it and fold it really hard. Alright, last one. Okay, I'm going to go around the edges and make sure that they're folded properly. Alright, and when it's done, we are going to flip the paper and make little make the edges fold. Alright, I think we need a little bit bigger. Would be nicer. So how much you fold determines the height of your petals. So if you fold this much, this is the height of your petal. Alright, so just make sure that you're folding relatively similar
little corners.
This one is a bit smaller than the rest, so I'm going to fold it again. Okay, and this needs a bit of effort to push down. Alright, so I'm going to take this petal and flip it up. So when you're doing this, just think of rolling motions. You're going to advance bit by bit and pull at the same time. There you go. And after it's up, you're just going to fix the paper by flattening it, pulling on it, and just make it a shape that you want it to be. You're going to do the same here. Push it. And a lot of the time you can rip the paper when you're doing this, so don't worry, you can just do it again. I ripped like 10 of them when I first made them. So make sure when you're doing it for the first time, use a paper that you are not going to regret using and ripping. Alright. Okay. We're going to fix it a little bit here. And the last one. Slowly advance. Push it. Pull it. And then fix it. Alright, so you will have something like this. You can always fix the petals later. And we're going to do another row of petals. So we have them right under. This one's ripped really easily, so make sure that you're pushing in the center when you're doing it. And then when it's almost up, you go to the edges and do them one by one. At this point, your previous row of petals might start to look a bit flat since you're pushing on them, so you can fix them up later. Alright, so that's how it looks for now. We're going to make sure the petals look nice, like they're blooming. But if you don't have a smaller paper, it's alright. You can make a smaller paper out of these things. So we're going to fold them in a rectangular manner. Make sure they meet up. Fold them in here. Do the same here. Alright. Now we're going to do another one. Okay. Let's move it up. example, if you see now, you'll have four smaller papers. We're going to just follow the fold lines here and do a reverse one. And this time, you're going to use your nails. So it's thin. And do the same right here. And use your nails. And this time I'm going to rip the paper along the lines. But if you can cut really well, you can use a scissor and use the sign as a guide and cut it. So make sure that it's really thin by folding it with your nails on both sides. And you're going to just thread it from the top. Make sure that you follow along the line with your finger so it doesn't break the far away from the line. So I'm going to thread it carefully, little by little. And I'll have a perfectly cut paper. I'll do the same right here. For this one, I only need two papers, so I'm going to put this away. Alright. And after making sure that it's thin enough, I'm going to rip it the same way, following with your finger. And you're done. Alright, we're going to use two leaves for this one. So let's start with the first one. They're the same. So first, make a triangle. Make sure that they meet up here. Make sure, since it's a smaller paper, doing triangles is a bit easier. Alright, and we're going to fold it. So, and we're going to do the next. Okay, and after that, you're just going to fold it like this. It doesn't matter the size. This is alright. And then look right here. Okay, we're going to tuck the edges in. And now you're going to make a heart shape by folding in the leaves. Just make sure when you're folding it, these lines match up. So, like that. Three leaf right here. And if you want to fold this edge, you can do that too. I think I'm going to make two different leaves, one this one folded and one without it. So this is the one without it. So, since this guy, it does not do a whole important role in the structure of the leaf, it's alright if it's a bit crooked. So, I'm going to do the same by folding it up. And I'm going to tuck the ends in. Fold the gratefulness. And I'm going to fold this one. Match up here. So it's another leaf. So with the flower and those leaves, and you can glue them if you want, or you can use them as a display and change the look up. And that's it for the lotus flower or the water lily. Yay! Good job!
Thank you, Ninjin. You are truly an origami master. You taught every detail with good explanation. A wonderful job! Ninjin also teaches how to fold lucky stars and tells a story about it. Watch her separate video. Goodbye!